So Sync is based on the Chromium Sync engine, so we started from that. And on top of that, we added a layer to an API layer to communicate with the UI side, JavaScript side. We also implemented our own login mechanism to connect to the engine. And then we also added our own notification server to replace what was already there. Then, since we had the API layer to communicate with the UI, we added UI functionality, which is the main part of being the settings themselves, and then two smaller items, which is the remote tabs icon in the top right corner, and then the sync status icon in the status bar. The infrastructure was actually quite a lot of work. We had to set up a server that was compliant with the sync protocol. So that mostly talks over secure HTTP, and then there's some protobuf thing going in the background. And that server communicates with a second server, which is sending out notifications. So whenever it receives something, it sends a notification to the notification server, which in turn notifies all the other vivaldi instances connected, and that's done over stomp, which is a standard protocol. And that allows every vivaldi instance to talk back to the server. And then we had to make this scalable and make sure that it would survive the amount of traffic we expect. I expect that the sync data will be entirely safe, and that's because we're using end-to-end encryption, which means that when you sync any kind of data, it gets encrypted by Vivaldi on the client, on the computer that is sending it, and what we receive on our server is purely encrypted, and we don't get the password to decrypt it. That's never sent to us in principle. When you want to retrieve your data, you have to get it in your Vivaldi browser again and decrypt it with your password there. So at no point do we actually receive any decrypted data or the password to decrypt the encrypted data.